Let's settle this once and for all. In a race to see who's best at emergency communication, it's DynaNet versus Cellular. DynaNet is made solely for emergency communication. Cellular is made to do a lot of things, but it is actually not designed for monitoring. Did you know that cellular companies are not accountable for monitoring call failure? Calls and data are processed in the same way. A tweet is the same thing as a fire. Test one, speed. DynaNet, 3 seconds. Cellular, 45 to 60 seconds. No contest there. Test two, technology. Cellular technology is always changing. So many G's, making it hard for equipment to work together. Not only does this cause monitoring communication issues, but you pay every time equipment needs updating. No updates mean emergency calls won't go through. DynaNet uses reliable military technology that is used by space systems and emergency services. Psst, and you didn't hear this from me, but National Fire Code requires test communication every 5 minutes. Some cellular providers set theirs a test every hour. DynaNet checks every 4.3 seconds, guaranteed. Test 3, network overload. During major sporting events and disasters, cellular networks can become overloaded. Cellular just can't tell the difference between an emergency call or anything else on their network. And we all want social media and streaming, but not at the cost of safety. Here's the last test of the day. Test 4, disasters. Cellular is very sensitive compared to DynaNet. Damage to a single cell tower can disrupt miles of communication. DynaNet's fault-tolerant network keeps going. During disasters, cell networks can be seized by emergency services. Good for handling a crisis, but bad if your property has an emergency. Emergency calls are seen just like any other call on cellular and can easily be cut. DynaNet just powers on because it exists to communicate during crisis. DynaNet beats cellular across the board in emergency monitoring. To do one thing perfectly is not a bad thing.